Hello, folks. Welcome back to Mordheim, City of the Damned. As always, of course, I am Falcon, your host. I will preface this immediately by saying, folks, please like and subscribe. It does help me out a great deal. Like this video, subscribe to my channel. Helps to grow my channel. It will really help me a lot. Also, please leave some comments down below. If you would like to talk to me, leave, you know, any suggestions for how to play this game or any of the other games I'm playing. Suggestions on games you'd like me to play in the future, comments on what happens in the video, whatever. I would love to hear from you no matter what. And all of these things will help with the current problems that YouTube are having with their subscription service, people being unsubscribed, and so on and so forth. It does help with that, all those issues. And please also check out my Patreon, the bottom of the in the description down below. Is a link to it, and coming into the new year here, there will be a great deal more interactivity possible between those two things once I revamp my Patreon and actually get it properly set up, really, because right now it basically just exists. By the time you actually see this video, it may or may not have already been done. I am recording this before I've done so, who knows, but... Going into the new year, though, there will be a great deal more interactivity, and it's going to help me interact with my community a lot more, and give the community, I think, some unique options that most communities for YouTubers don't get. And that is something that I really want to stress, and something that I would really hope that you folks will enjoy. So... we're going to go ahead and jump into this. First off, we are on the screen because I wanted to make note of the fact that all our people are back off of recovering from injuries in her case and training in all these other cases, and all of them, all of our henchmen are now in heavy armor, every last one of them. So they are all super tanky compared to where they were previously. You are still the tankiest of the bunch, maxing out at 50. Well, not quite maxing out, because if you had a purple helm, the purple helm might have some better armor, maybe. No promises on that, but at least has the potential to have better armor, and that would max you out at 55, probably. But having said that, we're as maxed out as we're likely to get, at least anytime soon. I do have another purple heavy armor in the inventory, so I could give it to one of these people, but the problem is all of them have ability bonuses on their thing, and I don't really want to... like, I have no purple armor buffs, certainly not ones that I would like to give them. So I kind of like having the bonuses that we get from with the blue armors that I have available. So, I am a little reluctant to give them a purple armor that doesn't have bonuses on it. And I think I'm actually going to save that purple armor for our leader. Because the arcane spell casting chance on the purple armor goes down to -5. Which I believe, if we look at other... yeah, so this is... -10 for blue armor. So it'll be the same as the armor that she's using, so she won't suffer penalties there, and of course will gain a great deal of armor. Although the initiative does go through the floor with heavy armor, which is the one real problem with it. But, well. Our people will be slow on initiative, but we will just be super, super tanky. So we are doing the quest this time around. So we're going to go ahead and basically just jump right into this. Everyone is set up as we desire them. I did get a purple hunting rifle, along with the same shop load that included that purple armor. I also got the purple light armor that our purifier is wearing, which I didn't show you guys, but she has purple light armor on. Which, of course, has upped her defense to be almost as good as one of these ones with the heavy armor. It's as good as it's going to get, essentially, because she cannot wear heavy armor. But, yeah, she's as set up, basically, as she can get. Actually didn't really want her... No, that's fine, that's fine. We're good. We're just gonna go. Go forward.
High
go forth.
Ogre Anya has been plagued with severe fever since her return to the Rock. The demonic corruption that taints her cannot abide the holiness of our fortress, and as it suffers, so too does the body it has violated.
That doesn't sound good.
Anya may yet perish from her affliction and be denied her chance to atone for her apostasy. Today, for the first time, the High Augur's delirium broke and she was able to speak.
Cool.
What she had to say was ominous. It seems a malignance of the Allures continues to haunt her, tormenting her with unsettling visions.
That's not good.
She could see a mighty champion of Sigmar, one of his Templars, ride into Mordheim to cleanse the ruins of the evil infesting it. Had Anya been able to give us warning of the champion, the Sisterhood could have set out to protect him. Instead, her fever silenced her tongue, and she was tortured by the visions of this great man and his entourage beset by the Brotherhood of Shadows. Though he fought valiantly, the Templar was captured. Taken to the old Raven barracks, the cultists sacrificed him to the dark gods. Though the champion has fallen, his body and his regalia remain in the hands of the heretics.
What are you doing over there?
The holy hammer with which he made battle against the cultists is a sacred relic forged by the dwarves, a weapon of tremendous power. The reliquary he brought with him is a Sigmarite talisman from the days of Grand Theogonus Gazulgrund. These treasures cannot be lost to the slaves of Chaos. More, we cannot allow the body of such a holy man to be left to rot in the ruins. His corpse must be brought back to the Rock, purified by the Sisterhood and entombed in a place of honor within our own crypts. The cultists remain in force at the barracks. We must purge the place of them and their filthy idols. Then we must reclaim Sigmar's own.
Very well, so let's go ahead and get on this. Our party is hugely powerful compared to where we were before. Like, we are just massively powerful in comparison to what we were capable of previously. We are so tanky, we have just so much damage potential and stuff now in comparison to what we could do the last time we did one of these quests. So, that's a ranged dude. Mutant. Okay, so that's their altar. Kill Magista Venari. Venerai, something, I don't fucking know, whatever. He's probably on the altar place. Explore the barrack ruins, that's just in general. Locate the holy hammer, let's see, there's 1, 2, 3. Look at the altar, we know that one. Which is probably going to have the corpse. Fair chance that it'll have the hammer and the reliquary as well, at least near to it. Because that's definitely something right there. That's something right there. That might be the body. Over here, I can't see what's over there, so I don't know. That might be, could be underneath, it could be on top, who knows. Okay, well, there's also a fair amount of wordstone in this level. It is kind of spread out a little bit. It's not real, real spread out, though. There's some right there, a little bit over there, and then the majority of it is in this general vicinity here. Although this is, like, a courtyard and a wall. So getting to it might be a little difficult, but it shouldn't be too horrible, I hope. Let's take a quick gander around the outskirts of this building. Who knows what's in there, because we can't really see anybody. That looks like it just ends there, because there's no... Oh, is this a breach in the wall? No, probably not. I mean, it is a breach in the wall, but it's not one that I think we can do anything with. So I don't think there's much point in looking at that. So we'll return you to your original starting spot. We'll have you scout this direction, because I just want to see up the wall here, see what we can see. Not expecting to really see much, but there might potentially be... No, it doesn't look like it. I was going to say there might be a way in over there, but it doesn't look like it. Looks like that's just a side alley that has no real practical purpose. I want you to open the chest, just because I want to see if there's anything in here that we need. Nope, okay. So we don't need an item or anything to purify the altar or some stupid shit like that. And you can actually plink away at a couple of dudes. So I think I want you to do just that. So go ahead and wail on these dudes. Because the more range damage we can do to them, the weaker we can make these guys at range, the better off we'll be. Particularly here, because this courtyard is a very open area, and it looks like they... don't really want to do that last one, because that last one is going to be... I think that's going to be pushing it a little too far. So let's probably not do that. Probably don't want to do that. Let's buff you with stimulus, because you are very slow, so that'll give you a chance to go a little sooner than you would otherwise. I don't think these guys have had an opportunity to go yet, so... that's a corn altar, by the way. Somehow we have to get up top. What the fuck is this thing right in front of me? What is this thing? Like spitting blood out around it or something. What the hell is that? Well, I mean, so far there's nothing but two dudes. Yeah, that's definitely the body right there. Could have something in it, could, may not, who knows. Either way, I think I'm just going to pull you back a little bit where you can't be seen by their snipers, because they might try to snipe you, and we'll just put you into ambush mode, because there's no real reason to do anything else. We have so many ranged options now. Okay, headshot, not a good idea, because... despite the headshot's not a good option in this instance. Sure, you have plenty of range to be able to try and hit him, but there's really not much point. What the hell do you have cover? Doesn't make sense. You shouldn't have any cover. There's no cover to be had. I call bullshit. No, but seriously, game, there is no cover. Whatever. Clearly lie, but it's fine. Okay, so go ahead. Shit. Okay, now I think I can shoot. Go ahead and try and hit him with the headshot. Excellent. Now you can reload. Oh, you don't have enough to aim and reload again. Fuck. Oh well. Not that important, really. Alright, blast him with a knee shot, then. Because why the hell not? Lowering his initiative is really not that important, but I will do so anyway. And then you can reload. You might as well just sit there, because there's really no reason for you not to. Now, unfortunately, you are much shorter range than the other person is, so I still call major bullshit that you are... I still call no end of bullshit that you are apparently... outside the range at which I can shoot you. I guess impact shot you might as well, because you'll get if you hit him, you'll do more damage. And you missed. Not that surprising, because it's not really giving you a good chance of hitting the dude. Just unfortunate, but I could try to aim and shoot here. But if we don't, you'll get to... you know what, we will. Because you do significant safe damage, which our other range capabilities are not going to do for us. Because our other range capabilities are spells, and there's always a chance that those could fail or otherwise backfire on us, which clearly would be bad. So, better to not risk that. Okay, well, there's at least a reasonable chance that this will kill the guy. It didn't. Oh no. What just happened? -2... it's not too bad. It's not great, but it's not too bad. Yeah, just go ahead and kill him. And you fucking suck. Good. Oh, and now you can't cast spells for a million years. Great. Great! Just what we needed. Just what I wanted to see. Alright, so I will move you in here a little bit. You can go in ambush mode right there. Just because I don't want to be stuck out here in the courtyard, basically. While we wait for these guys to do whatever the hell it is that they're doing. And there's another dude. Oh. Wait, what? Where? Where is this other guy at? Oh, hi. I did not see you. I hope you can't shoot my person. Because I did not know you were there. You probably can shoot her, though, which is not good, but... Oh, well? Question mark? Not like I can really do anything about it, so... I'll move you to right here, because the guy shouldn't be able to shoot you, and you should be too far away to hit, so... Okay, and you should be able to kill the one, at least. What the hell's renewal? Dude! Oh, that's a self-targeting one, too. Nice. Very good. Alright, sweet. I was not expecting that. I was not expecting that kind of capability from you. I am pleased by this. Alright, as much as I don't want to have you kill somebody, because that means nobody else will get that experience, but frankly, I would rather him die than him continue to live, so... target Resk, because he is the next most serious threat at present. Bam, bam. And you might kill him, maybe. Bam, didn't quite kill him. That's fine. Totally okay with him not dying from that. I want to know what this thing does.
New objectives added.
Remove the desecrated skulls. Okay. Ow. That hurt.
Objective updated.
Does that get rid of the effect? Please tell me that gets rid of the effect. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Fuck? Fuck, 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 fuck. Extremely bad. Extremely bad. Oh, Lord. Okay. That's no bueno. You have a self-heal, so you should be... We're not as bad off as we would have been previously. So I think I'll move in. I don't like it, but... Wait, what? You're shooting the bloodletter? And you're sucking horribly at it, apparently, but... Okay, so apparently the bloodletter is not on their side. So that's good. That's good, for what it's worth, which unfortunately isn't very much. Not very much at all, but for what it's worth, that is good. That isn't worth that much, but it is worth something, at least, I suppose. Okay, move over here so you can't be shot by that guy, because that guy hasn't gone yet. And unfortunately, of course, we have wasted all of our attacks on, from people who actually could have done something to this thing. Oh man, I do not want to attack this guy at all. I don't want to be anywhere near this thing. You can heal yourself is the thing. I think we don't go anywhere near him. I think we just leave him alone. I think that's the smarter option, because if we just don't fuck with the thing, I think we're better off. You don't have enough to be able to engage and then get out, so I think we just... We just don't. I really do. I really think it's smarter just to not even bother. Like, as much as I would like to attack it, it's just not a good idea. It's just not a good idea, so we're not going to do it. I would like to attack it, but I think it's better that we let it try to attack, better let it to attack her, because she has the health, and she has the ability to heal herself for a significant chunk of damage, which she couldn't do before, so I think we just do that. I think that's a much smarter decision than any other option that we would be able to even potentially do. Are you fucking shitting me right now? Can't get close enough to Snoking's decree on that dude. Oh, there we go. Okay. Sure. What's actually this guy's resistance? Oh, that's not too bad. Alright, so you should be able to... Except when he does that. God damn it. God damn it. Alright, fine. Just fucking put it on him, then. Are you shitting me? God damn it, game. Ow. No, that... You devils. Ow. Ow. Fuck.
A new rot has started.
Are you shitting me, game? Are you shitting me? It got to go twice. Fuck you. Oh, good. Just what we don't need. God damn it. And you're attacking the one fucking person I would not want you to attack, because he's like the weakest of all of our people. God damn it. Fuck you. Like, it's for real, game. Fuck off. Oh, look, it's the dude. He's apparently doing stupid... I don't understand what the hell you just did. Other than... Basically commit suicide? Really? Because, I mean, that's pretty much what's going to happen. You're not going to be able to do anything to me in here in a second, so I don't really know why you bothered. Yes. I think our... Or do I hold on to that to try and shoot somebody else? Or we can just do a normal shot. There's really no point in expending the extra shot damage. There we go. Got him. So there's one down. Reload. You get to shoot once more, and you can aim with it if I want to aim with it. Neither of these things... You have such a low chance of hitting anybody right now. Really sucks. I mean, I would prefer to hit the bloodletter. Problem is, your chance to hit is just so bad. I think we try anyway, though. Figures. But it was worth it. It was worth it, because the bloodletter is the biggest threat that they have. Really. I don't suppose you are close enough to heal both of them. You are. Sweet. Alright. Well, we need to do that then, because our one guy has gotten his ass kicked, and I need to kill the bloodletter before we try to do anything else. So, do not charge the bloodletter, please. That would be a very bad idea. Oh, hi, dude. How you doing? I would love to attack this guy, but... the bloodletter is by far the bigger threat. Like, that dude's nasty, but the bloodletter is infinitely nastier, so we need to concentrate on that. We need to concentrate on the bloodletter. So as much as I would love to have you target somebody else, bloodletter is way, way more dangerous. I don't know what the hell fervor is. Huh. Alright. Oh no, it was reduction on stuff. Eh. Whatever. Go ahead. And yeah, put it on her. She is... Ow. Well, that's not good. You're going to continue to take damage, then. What does Renewal do again? Up to 30 wounds. Okay. Like, we need to kill this thing. Like, ASAP. If we can kill it, then you can sit back, basically, and... heal yourself. Because we are in far less danger if we don't, if this thing is dead. So really, we need the bloodletter dead. I'm actually going to wait. You can kill it, which is why I'm going to wait. But I'm going to see if somebody else is able to kill the thing first. Because if somebody else can kill it, then you can heal yourself, which is useful. So, I would prefer that. How the fuck does this guy have cover? I don't understand. don't... He's right out in the fucking open. Seriously, game. Fuck you. You will not be able to reload a second time. So you're only going to get one attack. That's not good. Nothing I can do about it, though. Unfortunately. Can you get close enough? Can you aim and shoot? Because if you can aim and shoot... Yeah, I'll take that, because that will kill it. It'll give you experience, which would be nice. And that prevents anyone else from having to be feared in order to kill the thing. Which is useful. So, I will take that as a valuable bonus. I want to kill that dude, but he's less important than this guy. This guy's dangerous. This guy right here is dangerous. Oh right, you can't attack. You cannot attack, unfortunately. Yeah, just attack him then. God damn it. Fuck me. Crap. Oh well. Please hit him. Fuck. Come on, hit him! Thank you. I need to break, I need to pull our other dude out of battle with this thing. Because this guy's too dangerous. You should be reasonably safe where you are. But I should still probably move you to block the sniper. Because you are fairly hurt, so I don't want you to take any more damage than you already have. And you need to start healing yourself, because you are very badly hurt. So, if you can heal yourself enough, you can get yourself back to full strength, and then you'll be good to go. But right now, obviously, that does leave a bit to be desired. So you'd have a 70% chance to hit. Because of the fear, I think that's the better option. So do try to charge it on him then. Just because of the fear effect. Please hit him. God damn it, game! Oh, you did actually take the penalty, even though... Interesting. I didn't think it worked that way. I thought that if you charged... I thought it only affected you after you charged. Apparently that's not the case. That's not good. Oh well. Not actually that surprising, to be honest, but not good, nevertheless. Seriously. I mean, you have fun with that, but... I don't think there was ever any real hope of that hitting anything. There was something in there. How the hell do you even get to that dude? Like, seriously though, how the hell do you get to that dude? I don't want to attack this guy because of the stupid stuff on the ground. I think you're safe to it. Or not. God damn it. Oh, whatever. Alright, don't even worry about that dude then. Just position yourselves where they can't really shoot at us or anything, and we should be fine. Because at this point we can't engage on that dude because of the stupid blood any more than we already have anyway. Seriously? Call bullshit that you could even see me. Let alone shoot me from there. Whatever. That was some crap. But whatever. It's fine, I guess. Alright, do try to block these guys off from them sending any further reinforcements in, because that would be unpleasant. And yeah, so you need to make sure that you have enough to disengage with. So you can feel free to attack here, but then you need to back the fuck out. Yeah, so I already have to pull back, unfortunately. Cause you will die if you continue to stay near that dude. So you need to get the hell out of there, and you need to head over here, I think. Behind a wall somewhere where nobody will be able to shoot you or do anything to you. Actually, you know what? You know where I should send you? I should send you back out entirely. Because you're badly hurt and I don't want you to get killed, so. So just send you entirely, like, around the damn corner over here and you'll be fine over there. Nobody can attack you now, so you should be fine. This guy is going to cause us all sorts of problems, but not too bad, though. Are you fucking shitting me? There's another one? At least you took way worse wear. You took way more damage than I did out of that exchange. So that's good, at least. Hi, friend. You have made a terrible decision there, buddy. Ow, bitch. That suck. Yeah, you should not have moved. Just stayed right the fuck where you were, because you could have continued to do your... whatever the hell it is that you're trying to do. So you didn't even do anything. You're a failure. I mean, that's not true. You did do something, but you didn't do that much. All things considered, you're kind of a failure. You're kind of a failure. Not a complete failure, but you're kind of a failure. I think I need to kill this dude. Because that will free up a significant chunk of our firepower if we kill him. So let's try to kill him, shall we? Because if you can kill him, reasonable chance this will kill him right here. Excellent. Excellent. Okay, now, walk over here, and you can actually just attack this dude in his face. Hi, friend. How you doing? And then comment on the other guy because I don't want to get close to him. And you suck. Crap. What did that do again? Ugh. It's not good. This is not good. Well, I mean, whatever. It's not much point in doing that, but I guess. There's no point in not doing it, I suppose, so. Alright, your chances of hitting anybody are not very good, but. The This dude was able to shoot you with no problems, so you better be able to fucking return the favor. Are you shitting me? He's like right the fuck in front of you, dude. Are you fucking serious? Dude, he is literally right in fucking front of you. Do you have like a minimum range on this weapon or something? I guess you do. Bullshit! Bullshit, game. Seriously, bullshit. Absolute bullshit. Absolute bullshit. I swear to God. He is right the fuck in front of you. Like, I walked up to the goddamn thing to the point that you could have stuck it through and punched him in the face with it, and you still can't fucking hit him. Are you really shitting me right now? I swear to God. Fuck you, game. How are you still taking damage from that fucking thing? It's ridiculous. Alright, I want you to help kill this guy over here. Because this guy's nasty. No, please charge on this dude. Here we go. Man, that might kill him outright. Totally down for that. Alright. Fuck you, buddy. Killing this guy is important just because he is dangerous. Very, very dangerous. And because of the, damage potential, I don't want him to continue to be a threat. So I'm just going to remove him so he's no longer a problem. Now I could kill this guy, but I actually want you to heal somebody. Not necessarily yourself. Not necessarily yourself. Because I don't think you really need to be. You don't. I mean, you need healing, but you don't need it necessarily as much as some of our other people do, so. I don't anticipate you being able to hit anybody, but we'll give it a shot. We can give it a shot. There's no reason not to. Oh, actually, no. I don't want you to attack that. I want you to try and attack this pain in the ass over here. My friend. Seriously? What the fuck, game? This is just fucking stupid. Like, I am in this fucker's face, and I still can't... It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. I mean, if I was any bloody closer to him... Screw you, dude. Screw you. Oh, God damn it. Oh, and you still can't fucking do spells. Fuck my life. Fuck my life. It's annoying that you're still feared, even though you are no longer in battle with the thing that feared you. Even though the thing that feared you is dead. It is a little annoying that that's a thing. It's actually more than a little annoying, it's actually extremely annoying. But, whatever. Again, another person who's feared for no reason. Another person's feared for no practical reason. How long is that going to be a thing? Eh, only one more. It's not too bad, I guess. It's not great, but it's not too terrible. Could be worse. Alright, we need to try and kill this guy, though, because we need him dead. We need this dude on the dead side. You need to get out of that. Get out of the boiling blood, because that shit hurts. You are badly hurt now, which is unfortunate, but... Let's see. No, actually, I'm not going to do that. I would like to do that, but I'm not going to. So instead I will put you into ambush mode right here. You're too badly hurt. I don't want anything to be engaging on you if we can help it, so... Basically, if we can help it, I don't want anything to engage on you. Are you suffering some sort of, Oh yeah, the Cinder's thing. Okay. Him and then I'll almost kill him. And I'll almost kill him, and then hopefully somebody else can kill him. Hopefully someone else succeeds in killing him. I'm really annoyed that you're gonna be able to shoot now. Bullshit. But, whatever. You get more chances to hit him if you go in.
Night-night. Objective completed.
Take a nap, bitch. Oh, I already looted you. Never mind. I loot the other guy? I don't remember. Well, regardless, I want you to go in ambush mode so you can kind of hold this position. Make sure nothing comes out the door in front of us, basically. And yeah, that should be good then. Alright, so do this on this guy at least, so if when he attacks, he won't. He'll take damage at least. Which is ridiculously bullshit, but. Okay, whatever. You have no actual combat ability, unfortunately, so... with your spells, that is. You obviously have combat capability, but nothing with your spells, so... I kind of want to get all of the hurt people, at least vaguely in the same area, so that we can heal them with our leader.
A new round she has the has AoE. Started.
Alright, I don't care about just random dudes reinforcing, because they're not really going to be the problem. Like, this should let you heal the majority of the hurt people. Maybe not quite all of them, but it'll let you heal most of them. So if you go stand right here, will you get... No, you won't be able to get... It's just outside the range of it. Damn it. Bullshit, that won't heal him. That won't reach him. Had it healing everyone else a second ago. There we go. Alright, so it won't heal the guy who's most critically hurt, but it can heal everyone else, so... I'll take it. Ow. It's worth it. Ultimately does more healing than you took damage from. Once you are able- once you're better at the healing, then this will be really good, but... And then I need to actually use a courage real quick to make sure that everyone is broken out of the stupid, fear effect. And you can just kind of sit here, because there's nothing else that you can do right now. Nothing else that's that useful, anyway. I want this guy dead, please. There's also a chance that you're going to actually have to deal with people coming in from outside, because I don't know where any of these new enemies spawned from. So they could have spawned outside, and that could be bad, so we do need to actually be aware of that as a potential problem. It's not, you know, guaranteed to be a problem, but it is a potential problem. So it is something that we need to be aware of. That could become an issue. It's not right now, but it could be one. There. Fuck you, dude. You're a pain in my ass. And I actually do want you to pick up that loot, so... Small word stone in there, so nothing that I'm really that interested in. And I have no way, I have no idea how the hell you're even supposed to get in there, so I'm not actually worried, too worried about it. Really not too worried about it, so. Since I have no idea how the hell you're supposed to go in there in the first place. Are you fucking shitting me? You still failed the fear test. Fuck my life. Whatever. Alright, so this is actually going to be the end of the episode. Alas. Fuck. Hold on. What? Where? What the fuck are you talking about? Where? I'm gonna be back here to provide to protect her, because I don't want you to be attacked, her to be attacked. Apparently a dude spawned on top of you, which I don't understand, because I don't know where the hell you came from, but... Alright, fine. And now we need to send some people over here. Because we need to find out... Oh, hi there. How you doing? Actually don't want to engage on you, just yet, at least. Like, this looks like that should open this gate, but there's no way to open the gate that I can see. Short of trying to get that dude that had been in there to open it for us, which I don't know if that's even a thing, so... Yeah, about that. I mean, you can go over there, I guess, and wait for him. If he comes out the door, he's going to have a surprise that he's not going to be... He's not going to enjoy if he decides to try to come out here. Alright, and you need to heal people, because it's basically your primary mission right now. He has been badly hurt enough that he could die very easily. He could die very easily if he gets attacked again, so he needs to be healed. Heal him up to... Hell, you can get him to full. Yeah, I think just do that. Get him to full strength. Now... You're hurt, but you're not that bad off. You're a little hurt, but not too bad. Yeah, actually, heal her, because she's in kind of danger right now. Oh, you failed to heal. The heal. Okay. Well, that doesn't generally happen, but... I mean, it can happen, so... It just doesn't happen that often. We'll just continue to stay right where we're at right now, because there's really no reason for us to go anywhere else. Hi, buddy. You made a boo-boo. You shouldn't have come over here. But now... Okay. Sure, dude. Whatever you say. You can just leave everybody right where you're at, really, because I don't want anybody to get attacked. Well, hi, dude. How you doing? You have made terrible decisions in your life. Please don't hit him too hard. Ow. I just healed him. I just fixed him. Who's this guy? Where is this guy? Above us, I guess? I suppose. I don't know where the hell he is, so he must be up above somewhere. There's a skull thing in there. I want to look around a little bit before we make any decisions on where to go at the present moment. I think that closes that gate. One would presume. That should close this gate. Can you not get into that courtyard where the wordstone is from here? That's annoying. There was an underground area in this place? Oh my lord. This is going to turn into a very long mission, I think. Oh, Lord. This is going to turn into a very long, most unfortunate mission, I think. Which one are you? You are the one... Why do you not have any sort of attack abilities or anything? I thought I gave all of them attack abilities, so why don't you have something? I'm a little confused. Fuck you, acid breath. So if you do two normal attacks, you can actually hit him twice, so do that instead. That does more damage than one single stronger attack does. And we have actually reached... I guess I'll wait until the end of the turn. Actually, we'll just end this one, and then we're going to have to end the episode. Which is annoying, actually, but... how badly off is this dude? Very badly off. Okay. All right, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to have you delay, because I would rather this guy be able to kill him if he can, just because he needs the experience. He needs the experience more than the other guy does. I was going to say, come on, there's zero chance that you should be able to hit me with that. Your chance of hitting me with that was so low, I'm surprised you actually even bothered. To be perfectly honest with you. Surprised that you even bothered. The chances of hitting me was so bad. Hi friend, how you doing? Okay, and I don't think I can get anyone else over there, unfortunately. So you will have to just kind of hold your turn and just wait. Right where you're at. Oh shit, I forgot to loot that dude. Oh well, too late now.
A new round has started.
Fuck, really? More dudes? This is going to be one of those really annoying battles, isn't it? Where it's just going to be endless amounts of guys. I hate missions like this. Where they just keep coming. It's really annoying. They're really annoying. Oh well, let's go this way. Let's see what's over here. Surprise. And that shot will actually end our episode for today. So I will see you folks in the next one. Take it easy, have a good day, and thanks for watching. Bye-bye.